In this video, we take a look at the top 5 use cases of Apache Kafka. We explore how Kafka solves critical challenges in modern software architecture. Kafka started as a tool for processing logs at LinkedIn. It has since evolved into a versatile distributed event streaming platform. Its design leverages immutable append-only logs with configurable retention policies. These features make it useful for many applications beyond its original purpose. Let's start with log analysis. This has evolved beyond Kafka's original use at LinkedIn. Today's log analysis isn't just about processing logs. It's about centralizing and analyzing logs from complex distributed systems in real time. Kafka excels here because it can ingest logs from multiple sources simultaneously. Think microservices, cloud platforms, and various applications. It handles this high volume while keeping latency low. What makes modern log analysis powerful is Kafka's integration with tools like Elasticsearch, Logstash, and Kibana. This is known as the Elk Stack. Logstash pulls logs from Kafka. It processes them and sends them to Elasticsearch. Kibana then lets engineers visualize and analyze these logs in real time. The second use case is real-time machine learning pipelines. Modern ML systems need to process vast amounts of data quickly and continuously. Kafka stream processing capabilities make it a perfect fit for this. Kafka acts as a central nervous system for ML pipelines. It ingests data from various sources. This could be user interactions, IoT devices, or financial transactions. This data flows through Kafka to ML models in real time. For example, in a fraud detection system, Kafka streams transaction data to models. These models flag suspicious activity instantly. In predictive maintenance, it may funnel sensor data from machines to models that forecast failures. Kafka's integration with stream processing frameworks like Apache Flink or Spark Streaming is key here. These tools can read from Kafka, run complex computations or ML inference, and write results back to Kafka, all in real time. It's also worth mentioning Kafka Streams. This is Kafka's native stream processing library. It allows us to build scalable, fault-tolerant stream processing applications directly on top of Kafka. The third use case is real-time system monitoring and alerting. While log analysis helps investigate past events, this use case is different. It's about immediate, proactive system health tracking and alerting. Kafka serves as a central hub for metrics and events from across the infrastructure. It ingests data from various sources, application performance metrics, server health stats, network traffic data, and more. What sets this apart is the real-time processing of these metrics. As data flows through Kafka, stream processing applications continuously analyze it. They can compute aggregates, detect anomalies, or trigger alerts, all in real time. Kafka's pub-sub model shines here. Multiple specialized consumers can process the same stream of metrics without interfering with each other. One might update dashboards, another could manage alerts, while a third could feed a machine learning model for predictive maintenance. Also, Kafka's persistence model allows for time travel debugging. We can replay the metric stream to understand the system state leading up to an incident. This feature can speed up root cause analysis. The fourth use case is change data capture. CDC is a method used to track and capture changes in source databases. It allows these changes to be replicated to other systems in real time. In this architecture, Kafka acts as a central hub for streaming changes from source databases to various downstream systems. This process begins with the source databases. These are the primary databases where data changes occur. These databases generate a transaction log that records all data modifications, such as inserts, updates, and deletes, in the order they occur. The transaction log feeds into Kafka. Kafka stores these change events in topics. This allows multiple consumers to read from them independently. This is where Kafka's power as a scalable, durable message broker comes into play. To move data between Kafka and other systems, we use Kafka Connect. This framework allows us to build and run various connectors. For instance, we might have an Elasticsearch connector to stream data to Elasticsearch for powerful search capabilities. And a DB connector may replicate data to other databases for backup or scaling purposes. The fifth use case is system migration. Kafka does more than just transfer data in migrations. It acts as a buffer between old and new systems. It can also translate between them. This allows for gradual, low-risk migrations. Kafka lets engineers implement complex migration patterns. These include strangler, fake, and parallel run with comparison. Kafka can replay messages from any point in its retention period. This is key for data reconciliation. It helps maintain consistency during the migration process. In a large-scale migration, Kafka can act as a safety net. We can run old and new systems in parallel. Both can consume from and produce to Kafka. This allows for easy rollback if issues arise. It also enables detailed comparisons between old and new system outputs. That's it for a quick overview of 5 popular Kafka use cases. If you like our videos, you might like our system design newsletter as well. It covers topics and trends in large-scale system design, trusted by 1 million readers. Subscribe at blog.bytebytego.com.